Hey buddy, what's up man? You can't throw down? I come to your territory, you can't come to mine?
Hey buddy, how are you?
Good.
Yes. Hanson. Owen, nice to meet you, buddy.
Owen, who's your daddy?
Pete? Oh, nice. I know Pete. We're here, man. We're in Gloucester, Massachusetts. It's going down. New England world. People are freaking out. I had to come up here on the makeshift bed for stowaways to get ready for today. Too many people down there.
Oh, that's so gross when you do that.
That is seriously the grossest thing. That's how Tim cleans his glasses.
It's the best way. Salty on the inside, dirty on the outside.
God, one time I licked Ryan Trevon's heart rate monitor strap, and I put it on, and then he looked at mine, and he said to me, Powers, you just licked my heart rate monitor strap, and I just went,
That's way more gross.
It is a little bit grosser, but that's probably, that just grosses me out all around.
Powers rolls down the window and throws the anchor out.
I mean, the thing about the Caprices, man, is that she never will give up. She just won't stop. How can I retire her if she doesn't want to stop?
Give it to me. I need a car to go to work.
I think we need to raise it.
It's only got to go like 20 miles every day.
On it.
Yeah. The thing is that the emissions on it is from is from March of 2010. That's how much I drive it.
It doesn't even have a catalytic converter. It's just a pipe coming out of the block.
Nice.
It is. You know what the good thing about it is that it's exclusive. Other people don't have it.
That's true.
And that's why I drive it.
No, there's one that comes in the parking lot at the plaza every day, just like that.
Not that color.
I'm like, man, that thing needs a mate. That'd be sweet.
I bet it's not a V6 though.
I didn't think that car.
That's like Tiny Tim, man. That thing is strong. Look at it. She's beautiful, and she won't die. She is still sharp. No, she's weathered a lot of storms, man. It's 2010.
Like
the thing was born 20 years ago. That's like,
that's pretty sweet.
It's a long time ago. It's a long time ago. So I want to make sure that it's, you know, this is kind of like in 2005. Remember that time when you put me to the gates? Yeah. This time when I go by, I'm gonna go Jeremia Potenza. Pah! Is that cool?
All right, good. Yes.
He took me to the barriers, 2005, the World Championships. I didn't even know who he was. This little Italian guy taking me to the barriers and the ice. Here we are, sunny Gloucester, 2010. It only makes sense. You want to say hi? Hello, that's Luca.
No, what's actually happened was just Jeremy was always bunny hop on the ice, the barrier. So it was like, piss me off. And wasn't really me, the guys push him on the body. It was my teammate Italian. We actually are two Italian versus one American, and we won that contest. At the last lap, my teammate pushed Jeremy on the body. Yeah, it was kind of bad move, but still a racing move too. It was funny. So we always joke about that. But this winter is gonna be again Sam Vanden, so probably have another fight.
So one of the guys that makes all this stuff here at Cannondale Cyclocross World possible is my buddy Troy. Troy drives from, you guys saw him at the training, at the team launch in at cyclocrossworld.com headquarters. He was there. That was like 3 weeks ago. Then you guys saw him in Las Vegas. He was there. He drove there. Then you saw him in Wisconsin. He was in Wisconsin. Actually, you guys might have not seen him, but he was there. Now he's back in Massachusetts. And then where are you going next, Troy?
This is Troy. Welcome, Troy, to the show. Oh my God, the applause. The crowd's going crazy.
We'll be a short trip, Providence next weekend.
Providence next weekend.
And then we have a week out of the country. And then we're in Louisville, Kentucky. From there we go to Boulder.
All right.
Then Fort Collins, another short trip. And we're in Belgium for a few weeks. Portland.
And then we're going. Then you gotta drive across the country again.
Yep.
There's a lot of driving in the truck, man. Yep. What's that like for you on the day to day?
Tell the people what that's like. A lot of thinking time. A lot of thinking time. You might rock out with a Jeremy Powers mixtape once in a blue moon.
That's right. Let's
be real about it.
Well, we are waiting for delivery of said mixtape.
Listen, all right, it's coming. All right. So can we show the folks what's going on in here? We got a pretty mean spread, so let's do it. Let's show the people what's popping.
We have four different treads to choose from. These are all the spares. The bikes all travel with their own spot, so Jeremy's bikes are here. Bikes travel with their wheels in front of them, just like this. We have spare bikes, plenty available. Everything we need, spare frames. Essentially, the rule is we travel with 10 of everything, so we don't take any chances.
What is the craziest thing that's happened on the road? Like, where you had to, like, you had some guy, he was road raging. I'm not talking about the girls doing the crazy stuff on the highway. We know about that. I want to know about the one guy that was, like, really taking it to a next level on the road rage kind of thing, and Troy had to get out of the car and drop some elbows. I don't know if that's happened, but you tell us. Maybe that has happened.
Yeah. In Cramer Junction, California, we were at the truck stop filling up, and a full-on trucker fight broke out. The small trucker was taking a camera phone picture of, like, big meaty trucker's girlfriend's ass. Takes a picture of it. You know, big guy fresh out of prison sees it happen. Just grabs guy and throws him through all the racks. Me, Doug Dalton, and I are in the cab. Each of us are going for a shotgun saying, uh-oh.
That's life on the road. Cannondale, baby. That's our boy Troy. All right,
trucker fights keep you on your toes.
That's right. Did they have spurs on their boots?
Didn't look that low.
Okay. Yeah. Well, and that's all I've got for you guys behind the scenes in the Cannondale truck. Life on the road with my man Troy.
Where can I get one of you T-shirts?
Yeah. You can get them right at the big green trailer. Ask the man.
I threw mine in the garbage over there.
Yeah, oh, you threw yours in the garbage. That's good. No, but yeah, over at the trailer.
Gentlemen, do your job.
Top 10, Justin Levine, big number 11, gonna take
go,
five
Jeremy,
laps to go.
Jeremy.
Really coming out of your view right now there, Larry.
Come on, K-Ball, let's go!
Well, we are just coming up on just about the halfway point of our time.
Yeah, Chris is shouting, riding through. He's got number four, his teammate, Jay Powell, Jeremy Powell.
I did the Jeremy Powers first lap as hard as I could go and blew myself and turned back, and Ryan and Tim were both there, and I was like, cool, this is going to be such a hard day. And then Ryan came by me like I was standing still, and
Well, you went down here and bobbled.
I did. We all bobbled. Yeah. Actually, it was kind of, yeah, we all, I don't know if Tim bobbled, but eventually he did up in the back section, and that was just that was just from going hard. You can see it in everyone's rhythm when they're just like going 110%, that, you know, we start making mistakes and guys start unclipping, and it's really, really sandy out here. Well, loose today. The grass is loose on some corners. It's really just washed out, and then just the rocks and stuff in the corners made it like no one that I saw all day didn't put their foot down. So
the gazebo, the pavilion, whatever you want.
The bike race that I did up in Vermont, I hit it on something that was hanging in the course.
So you could go around the course and trim everything.
I
I agree with that. Although this was more of a monument. It was a cow, a sculpture of a cow. I hit it with my hand.
I know.
He was hanging his beak into the road. Yes.
What is that?
Well, this is water. I'm just trying to clean my face so I can go over and look halfway presentable.
Oh, you do? All right, yes. With my broken finger.
Are they both broken or just one?
Just one, but we do the buddy system. We tie one to the other. So the other one has a buddy. So you're hanging out together. We gotta go this way. Isn't a bad view, is it? Did you come here for?
Podium girl.
Yeah, this is my niece.
Tim, I'm gonna grab a quick word with you while you're here while we're waiting for the rest of the podium. So, here comes your teammate making his way down, but
first place, Mr. Jeremy Power. The big beer at the Grand Prix of Gloucester, greatbrewers.com, the big sip. Arms up, gentlemen.
You know, like a liquid bandage?
Yeah.
We'll be here tomorrow. We're gonna do the same thing tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow.
Stings a little bit.
Yeah.